Just a quick note before we head to today's battle, 67% of the people who watch this Versus series are not subscribed to the channel. If we change that, we could make a huge impact in the Pokemon community towards more creative and fun content and help us reach our ultimate 100k goal. So if you could take those 3 seconds to click the subscribe button if you're enjoying the videos and you don't want to miss future battles, that would mean the world to me as it really does help a lot. Thanks guys, enjoy the video. Welcome to the final round 2 matchup in the True Power Versus series. Today we've got a really exciting match between two powerhouse trainers with quite an interesting type matchup too. Last time we saw the return of Professor Oak battling in an exceptional match against Gym Leader Erica of Celadon and showing just what he has to offer as a trainer as well as a researcher, but with Erica holding her ground amazingly well. Today we've got a battle between Gym Leader Sabrina of Saffron City versus Brock of Pewter. Brock of course came out with that surprise win against Elite Four Koga to earn his spot in this matchup, so we'll see how he can fare against a force as strong as Sabrina. If you haven't already, make sure to check out these trainers' True Power episodes to figure out how we establish their best teams using their actual main series games appearances. Let's now take it to the team previews to see which Pokemon each trainer is working with. Sabrina enters the tournament with a terrifyingly powerful looking team with defensive threats in Slowbro and Wobbuffet, powerful tanks like Metagross and Espeon, and sweepers like Alakazam and of course her Mewtwo, which we saw her use in the exclusive Unova Pokemon World Tournament a few years ago. Brock is of course rocking his Sandstorm team with very tanky Pokemon overall, but a little bit of speed here and there to balance things out with Pokemon like Aerodactyl. Word has arrived that our trainers are ready for battle, so let's make our way to the arena to see how this plays out. The final round 2 matchup, Brock of Pewter City versus Sabrina of Saffron. Brock starting off with his Tyranitar, arguably one of the biggest threats for Sabrina's team right here, where Sabrina's going to go in with the Espeon. Now this is an interesting matchup, definitely. Sabrina not looking to be in the best of positions. Tyranitar starting off the Sandstream to help out Brock's team probably a lot. We're going to have to see how Sabrina decides to deal with this. There's not much she can switch into on a Tyranitar. Going in with the Slowbro. Slowbro, a very defensive Pokemon for sure, but a crunch from Tyranitar, I don't know, but the... Oh, it looks like a Cobra Berry on the Slowbro, weakening the power of the Dark-type moves. So Slowbro actually going to be able to tank that first crunch relatively well, although with Sandstorm damage and perhaps the Tyranitar outspeeding on the second turn, here comes another crunch from the Tyranitar. Slowbro getting some big damage off on it. However, it can now respond. Let's see what Sabrina's up to, going for the Scald. The Scald should do a decent amount of damage on that Tyranitar, but it all depends if she gets the burn. That's the key here, and it does, the burn on the Tyranitar. Tyranitar is now severely crippled, so a very, very risky play from Sabrina, but it seems to have paid off. The Tyranitar is now crippled, the biggest threat to her team, and she's going to switch again into the Wobbuffet, deciding not to sack the Slowbro. Interestingly enough, Tyranitar crunch on the Wobbuffet. With that burn, it might not do that much. Yeah, just a little below half in terms of damage. Now, Wobbuffet's defense did fall there, and it's going to get hit by the Sandstorm, but it looks to have another berry coming out. The berry is a Citrus Berry. Citrus Berry on the Wobbuffet. Tyranitar getting hurt by that burn. We'll have to see if another crunch can do it. This is going to be close. There's a lot of factors to consider. The defense drop, the attack drop, and no, the Wobbuffet survives the crunch and uses Destiny Bond. Here comes Sabrina's strategy all into play. The one way possibly that she has to deal with this Tyranitar is the Wobbuffet. The Wobbuffet using Destiny Bond, and it of course does have that Shadow Tag ability, so once it goes down, oh boy, yep, Tyranitar is locked in there. It was unable to switch, had to make the attacking move to take down the Wobbuffet, but the Destiny Bond bringing down the Tyranitar along with it. What a brilliant play there from Sabrina, making sure that she took down the biggest threat, and the Sandstorm is now down. So a very, very complex set of plays there, but Sabrina playing absolutely brilliantly, now sending out the Slowbro against Brock Steelix. Brock has Steelix on the field, and the Steelixite is here. Brock Mega Steelix is on the field. His ace, his absolute stellar Pokemon that we saw do an amazing job against Koga, is now on the field, but Slowbro coming in with the Scald. Now, Steelix is specially defensive on Brock's team. However, that Scald doing over half, and it gets the burn as well. Are you kidding me? Sabrina making some massive plays here. The Steelix is going to go in with the Earthquake on the Slowbro to be able to take it down. But that burn is going to cripple it severely. Sabrina getting some luck with these burns here, but definitely, definitely a deserved play taking down that Tyranitar. Now she sends in the Espeon against the Steelix, the Mega Steelix. Espeon definitely going to be able to outspeed that Steelix with the Shadow Ball. Can it take it out, though? No, the Steelix survives and goes for the Heavy Slam. Now that burn, of course, going to lower the damage there, so we'll see if it... No, not enough. It might have been enough without the burn, but bringing Espeon a little bit below half after leftovers, and Steelix getting hurt with that burn, the Espeon will definitely be able to respawn here with another Shadow Ball, taking down the Mega Steelix. So Mega Steelix doing some big work, definitely, but perhaps a little bit less than it could have done, certainly, because of that burn. So Sabrina pulling off some massive Scald plays here. This is an interesting matchup so far. Brock coming out with the Aerodactyl now. Aerodactyl, one of the fastest Pokemon in the game, in the entire metagame, really. Aerodactyl going to be able to outspeed that Espeon, and Sabrina doesn't know what it's going to do, so she won't switch. The Espeon should probably go down to this Earthquake from the Aerodactyl. Yes, it does. The Espeon is down. Brock's fastest Pokemon for sure, and one of the few fast Pokemon that he has on his team. Putting in some work here. Sabrina sending out the Alakazam. Now, these are two very fast Pokemon, but Aerodactyl will outspeed unless... The Alakazite from Sabrina! Mega Alakazam is on the field, the one way she had probably to outspeed that Aerodactyl entirely. For anything to outspeed an Aerodactyl, actually. Here comes the Alakazam. What is it going to do? The Psychic, the Stab Psychic from the Alakazam onto the Aerodactyl, and oh, the Aerodactyl survives and comes in with the Earthquake for the response. How much is this Earthquake going to do on the Alakazam? It should do a lot. Whoa, a whopping amount of damage from the Aerodactyl. Alakazam now below half, but able to respond and outspeed yet again. Now Brock is in a very, very dangerous position here because Alakazam is a fast, fast Pokemon and also a specially offensive Pokemon. Most of Brock's Pokemon are physically defensive given that rock type, but Alakazam gonna go with the Focus Blast and it misses! Oh! Kabutops has X-Scissor taking out the Alakazam undoubtedly! Whoa, what a play that was! Wow, the Focus Blast actually missed the Kabutops. That was crucial. Brock yet has a chance here. That Mega Alakazam could have possibly swept his entire team. But no, Kabutops with that X-Scissor move coming in against the Metagross as well. Metagross now using Earthquake. That should probably take out that Kabutops. Metagross has a whopping attack stat, but Kabutops surviving. Looks like it has the Focus Sash. So surviving that. However, Metagross does probably have a priority move. Kabutops does too, though, the Aqua Jet and the Bullet Punch on the Kabutops, out-prioritizing that Kabutops. That Metagross is putting in some big work here. How is Brock going to respond to it? Sending out the Rhyperior. Rhyperior is a physically defensive monster, that is for sure. But can the Metagross take it down with the Stab Meteor Mash, one of the most powerful moves in the game? Oh, and the Rhyperior survives just barely. Hanging on there with yellow health and the Earthquake from the Rhyperior gonna do some massive damage on that Metagross, definitely taking it down. Rhyperior's attack stat is massive and that is a stab move. Metagross going down and Sabrina is on her last Pokemon. Here it comes, the beastly Mewtwo. Mewtwo, of course, we saw from Sabrina in the Black 2 and White 2 World Tournament. And now it is making a show here with the Aura Sphere. That cannot miss against the Rhyperior. It's absolutely decimating it. Now Brock has one last chance to deal with a Mewtwo. This is not looking good at all for him. Omastar is on the field. Let's see what Omastar's chances are against an Aura Sphere, a super effective Aura Sphere from the Mewtwo. And it survives. What? No way! Omastar surviving the Aura Sphere, coming in with the Hydro Pump and doing a whopping amount of damage, but not quite enough. The Mewtwo looks like it should be able to respond here with another Aura Sphere to take down the Omastar. My word! What a battle that was. Sabrina having to pull off some ridiculously complex plays in the beginning to handle that Tyranitar lead. A very good choice there from Brock, starting off with the Tyranitar, completely throwing off Sabrina's strategy. And of course, that Mega Alakazam Focus Blast missing was key for Brock. Brock had a few little lucky plays at the end there, but Sabrina did get pretty lucky with the burns early on. But ultimately, that Mewtwo, the deciding factor in this battle. And Sabrina will be moving to the quarterfinals. If you guys enjoy this battle and are looking forward to the rest of the tournament, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe with notifications on so you don't miss the next matches. Before we go, I'd like to thank the patrons who are making this tournament possible. If you guys want to help further this series' potential and support it, the link to my Patreon page will be in the description below. That's all for this one. This has been Soul Spectre, and I'll see you guys next time for more True Power.